Good morning, South Plainfield. Today is Monday, October 31st, 2022. Happy Halloween. I'm Shannon O'Flaherty.
And I'm Happy Halloween, Jake Shapiro. You're watching TigerTV.
There will be an investment club meeting Tuesday, November 1st in room 247, immediately after school. There's a pizza sale today after school at exit 10. Stop by and grab a slice to fuel you up before you go trick-or-treating. The boys' soccer team will be in Belleville today in the Section 2 Group 3 state quarterfinal round. Good luck, Tigers! As leaves across America make their annual autumn pilgrimage from the treetops to the ground, lawn and wildlife experts say it's better to leave them around than to bag them. First, because it keeps leaves out of landfills. Every year, about 8 million tons of leaves end up there. And second, because leaves help the grass. Leaves are full of nutrients, including nitrogen, phosphorus, and potassium. The best way to leave the leaves is to run them over with a lawnmower or rake them up in a mulch bed. Thick layers left on the ground will block light and grass won't be able to photosynthesize.
October is Breast Cancer Awareness Month. Recently, I spoke to Ms. Pinelli, who teaches 8th grade history at the South Plainfield Middle School. Her grandmother and Aunt Teresa both had breast cancer, but unfortunately lost their battle. I asked her a few questions about their battles and hear the responses.
Hi, my name is Ms. Pinelli, and I was asked to talk about my experiences with cancer.
What was it like when you found out that your grandmother had cancer?
I was 5 years old when I found out that my father's mother had breast cancer. And being five, I was pretty young, so I didn't understand. I just remember visiting her in bed and her saying, Biagia, Biagia, in Italian, it meant beautiful. I remember shortly after that, she passed away. And the family and the friends were very, very sad. My dad told us that after the surgery, she stayed in bed and she died within 6 months.
What was it like when you found out your aunt had cancer?
My aunt, which was my father's sister, had breast cancer in her 20s and survived. But unfortunately, it returned in her 80s. She tried everything. She even went on an experimental drug. But again, within 3 months, she passed away.
What was your experience with thyroid and skin cancer?
My family, my friends were phenomenal. They came to my aid. My sister went and called all these people that she knew were surgeons. I think once I realized that it wasn't going to be a really, really bad surgery, I started feeling better about it. I was only out of school for 2 weeks, and when I realized I won the battle, I felt great. But once I hit 5 years, I felt exceptionally good. I am pleased to say that on December 27th, I will be 12 years cancer-free. And about a year and a half ago, I found out I had skin cancer, and they cut it out, and every part's been fine since. So I like to always tell my students, cancer doesn't mean death. You can survive from cancer. You just have to take care of yourself.
Thank you for sharing your experiences, Finale. I'm a part of the Passionate Pink Club here in high school. Every Friday, members of the club come around with baskets of goodies that you can buy. Make sure to buy from them and spread awareness to breast cancer.
There'll be a broadcasting club meeting Tuesday after school in room 102. Be there. Disney and Marvel Studios' Black Panther Wakanda Forever had its world premiere in Hollywood on Wednesday. The official reviews for Wakanda Forever will be lifted on November 8th, but the early reactions on social media have lifted after the premiere. It is said that Wakanda Forever is as epic as Marvel sequels get. The story is hugely ambitious and thematically rewarding, with gut-wrenching twists and turns throughout. The 30th feature entry in the Marvel Cinematic Universe hits the theaters November 11th. Buy your tickets now. Continuing on the topic of Black Panther, platinum recording artist Rihanna released her first single for the Wakanda Forever soundtrack on Friday. The singer gave us the song entitled Lift Me Up for the upcoming Marvel sequel. The Umbrella singer hasn't released an album since Anti back in 2016, which logged at number one on the Billboard 200 charts for 2 weeks. Though she's teased her next album several times since, no new solo music has emerged, as the new mom has mostly focused on her Fenty Beauty brand. Who knows when the next time we'll get to know if your mind's in Disturbia. It's like the darkness is the light. Disturbia, am I scaring you tonight? Your mind's in Disturbia. Ain't it used to what you like? Disturbia, Disturbia. Bum bum beatum.
That's it for today's announcements.
Happy Halloween, South Plainfield.
Ooh.